37-year-old Christopher Ahn and dissident Adrian Hong were two of the members of the resistance group known as Free North Korea.
What they have done is really God's work over a long period of time. Kim Jong-un had his half-brother, Kim Jong-nam, murdered. Well, what this group did was it extracted and saved Kim Jong-nam's relatives, including his son, because they were targeted for assassination.
My name's Kim Han-sol. My father has been killed a few days ago. I'm currently with my mother and my sister, and we're very grateful to Adrian.
But that we have a responsibility to protect these individuals.
You haven't seen your sister for exactly a decade. We wanted to give you an opportunity to send her a message.
I still haven't given up my hope to see you.
The resistance group known as Free North Korea went into the North Korean embassy in Spain last February. The North Korean diplomats say they were held hostage and beaten. But Hong's lawyer says that's nonsense. Free Joseon was invited to enter the embassy, and there was no attack or forced entry. The North Korean accounts are now contradicted by the CCTV images released by the Spanish authorities. I have seen the video from inside the embassy. The video section that I saw shows a North Korean diplomat sitting at a table laughing.
They were probably invited in. This probably was an inside job.
But why would members of a group which wants to overthrow Kim Jong-un be invited into that embassy?
It is there where the defections generally occur.
This was a botched attempt to get one of those senior North Korean diplomats to defect.
Hong's group tried to get a top embassy official to defect with a stash of thumb drives, hard drives, computers, and at least one cell phone.
The group took thumb drives out of the North Korean embassy in Madrid. They gave them to the FBI. And this is important because North Korean embassies are really centers of crime.
The North Korean embassy in Madrid has been identified by experts as a hub of illicit activity, running contraband, selling arms to hot conflict areas all over the world.
I'm sure that we found a lot of information about how North Korea launders money through Europe because of the information that this group gave to federal authorities.
Another reason why Western intelligence might benefit from information on those computers, Kim Hyuk Chol, Kim Jong-un's point man in nuclear negotiations with the United States, was posted to that same North Korean embassy in Madrid.
So, the FBI, if they apparently had this material, instead of thanking them, they turn around and put the handcuffs on them.
Well, that's because of the Spanish extradition request.
Spanish authorities have asked the U.S. to find and arrest Adrian Hong. His face is plastered on a U.S. Marshal's wanted poster. U.S. authorities raided Hong's apartment last month, but he wasn't there.
Police!
The North Koreans call it a grave terrorist attack.
Should our government prosecute an American based on the claims of a North Korean?
Well, no, and we shouldn't extradite these people to Spain. The Spanish should never have asked for extradition in the first place. Ahn is an American citizen. He's a Marine who was honorably discharged.
Still, analysts say Hong's group has succeeded in embarrassing the violent and vindictive North Korean dictator.
We know from credible sources that the North Korean government is seeking Adrian Hong and some of his associates to target them for assassination.
I mean, he's assassinated or executed any number of senior officials that he saw or perceived to be a threat.
North Korea's top man at their embassy in Rome, well, he vanished into thin air along with his wife. He is still not resurfaced.
So he would go after these members as much as he could.
Analysts say there is no doubt Kim Jong-un's regime has its operatives tracking members of this group all over the world, likely trying to kill them.
Should America, and how can America support this group, and what do you think should happen to Adrian Hong and to Christopher Ahn?
Well, ultimately, they should be allowed to live in the U.S. I mean, the problem is going to be we're going to have some pretty difficult conversations with Madrid, because obviously this extradition request should never have been made in the first place.